It was around 4:30 when I went to my locker. I just came back from the gym after working out for about an hour. I was going to go get my coat that I left because it got cold out, and I saw the kid standing from my locker just staring, which is really weird. I knew this kid. He sat in front of me in Spanish class. We didn't really have too good of a relationship, you could say. I pretty much thought this kid was a total whack job, to be brutally honest. And I let him know it, too. Honestly, I wasn't the nicest person to him. I thought he was a freak. I'm pretty sure everyone else thought that too, they just didn't say anything. He did a lot of weird things in class, like mutter under his breath and stare at people. He just looked like a total weirdo too. So I used to pick on him and push him around and stuff. He always just took it too, never stood up for himself, so I didn't really think much of it. That morning though, before class, I saw him doodling on a piece of paper at his desk, so I swiped it from him. I guess he got mad because he tried to swipe it back, but I just held it out of his reach. It was a poem, a really creepy one. It was really dark and disturbing to read. I crumpled it up and tossed it into the trash, and he just sat there staring at his desk. I just thought this kid's a freak, and sat down on my desk behind him. All through class, though, he just kept staring at his desk, not moving. He didn't even look like he was breathing. And when class was over, I knocked him over as he stood up and laughed at him. Afterwards, though, I saw him reaching into the trash to get his paper. I didn't think of it then, but I guess that poem was about me. Which is why he probably got mad when I took it. Yeah, you think I'm a horrid person now, but I sure as hell didn't know this would come of it. Anyway, when I came back from the gym to my locker, I saw him standing there like he'd been waiting. I started telling him to get lost, and before I knew it, he whipped out a gun and shot me right in the shoulder. It all just happened too fast. I felt the shock and the blood pop out, and after that, I guess I must have hit my head on the floor and went out, because I don't remember anything except waking up in the hospital. But don't start blaming me for all this either. Yes, sure, I was a jerk, but it wasn't my fault this happened. Don't blame me.
Looking back at it now, that school day was such a blur. But everything becomes so clear from the second I went back to school at about 4:40. As I rushed into the building, hoping to just grab my book and get out of there. I mean, that school always seemed so eerie to me after hours. As I made my way towards the lockers, I could feel myself quiver when the sound of a gunshot echoed through the hall. As I looked around the corner, I braced myself for what I thought would be a frightful sight. I went into a state of shock when I saw Rob on the ground bleeding, and the shooter shook there as he stood still, pointing the gun at him. Without thinking, I ran to Rob, hoping he wasn't fatally wounded. He seemed to be knocked unconscious from falling, and it seemed like he was shot in the arm. I took off my sweater and tried to stop him from losing too much blood. But before I knew it, the shooter was aiming the gun at me. He told me he didn't want to hurt me, but I had to step away from Rob. I followed his orders and feared my life. I began to cry, hoping he would feel sorry for me and tell me that I could go so I could get help. Unfortunately, he became angry at me for witnessing the shooting and ruining his plan. He told me I couldn't leave because I'd seen what happened. He continued standing there pointing the gun at me and seemed too concentrated on figuring out how to get out of the mess. Thinking the solution to his problem would be killing me, my fears took over my body and I blacked out.
He and I had drifted pretty far apart at that point. I guess he trusted me enough to tell me about his plan. And I shouldn't have taken it so lightly. I just wasn't worried because I didn't think he had the guts to go through with it. He had eavesdropped on Rob to figure out when he would be alone at school, which was around 4:30 or so. And I called him at around 4:35-ish, and he didn't pick up his phone. That was when it hit me that he actually might do it. I remember that I had been on a horrible ice trip. It was like a 5-hour thing, and I flipped out and I rushed to school. The thing is, I've known him since we were 10 years old. Sure, he didn't really get along with the in crowd. Neither of us did. But it never crossed my mind that he had the ability to physically hurt someone, let alone hold a person hostage and shoot another. Anyway, when he saw me rush in and noticed Rob on the floor and Amber trembling at gunpoint, it's like he knew all bets were off. I could see it in his eyes. He was telling me, "Go to hell, Liz." I had screwed up his plan. Even though I felt like the room was spinning, I knew I needed to talk him out of this before someone else got hurt. He really was a good kid. He really was, and I told him so. I told him he was worth so much more than the stupid thing he was doing. I barely remember what happened next, only that I became hysterical, completely hysterical, and he started sweating a lot. He was freaking out. He was breaking down. All of a sudden, I hear the gun go off, and then silence. Silence so quiet, my ears rang, and it hurt, and he fell to the floor. I can't believe it happened. I can't believe I didn't stop it. I just still can't believe it. I lost faith in my judgment. I lost my best friend. And now, even a year later, I'm still looking for the part of myself I lost that day.